let's get this party started, okay? Yes, doesn't it feel good to be in person? Oh my goodness, I'm so glad to be here. Well, my name is Jody Long, and I am so excited to welcome you to the 5th annual Inspiring Women of Iowa, presented by Lincoln Savings Bank. We are so excited to be back in person this year, and of course, virtually. And today, we are recognizing women who truly exemplify courage, confidence, and character. Also, the advocates and businesses who support them. So if you are here in person, please feel free to enjoy your meal at any time, including a nice little tasty dessert, and it's Girl Scout cookies themed, of course. And for those of you who don't know me and who also don't wake up at 4:30 in the morning, I am Jody Long. I anchor on Channel 13, the Today in Iowa morning show, Monday through Friday. I love what I do, and I've done plenty of wonderful stories with Girl Scouts of Greater Iowa, so I'm thrilled that they invited me back this year. Aside from being on TV, I am a wife and a mother of a little toddler who I just love to boast about, so I just had to sneak him in there. Enough about me, but the individuals we are honoring today have dedicated time and energy to do more, to experience more, to make a bigger impact in our community, to be courageous leaders and visionary change makers. We hope this event leaves you feeling inspired, hearing the stories of these truly amazing people. The proceeds today fund the mission of Girl Scouts of Greater Iowa. It's an organization many of you may have experience with. Maybe that's because you sold cookies once before, went to camp, or have a Girl Scout in your house. Now I'd like to welcome the 2021 Inspiring Women of Iowa event chair and Girl Scouts of Greater Iowa board member, Brooke Quinn.
Good afternoon. I'm Brooke Quinn, and on behalf of the Girl Scouts of Greater Iowa, I welcome you to the Inspiring Women of Iowa celebration. Since 2017, this event has recognized women of courage, confidence, and character, the change makers, the women who are defining and clearing a path for aspiring young girls. Your support of this event allows the critical mission of Girl Scouts to continue, and for that, we sincerely thank you. This past year has certainly been a challenging one. I can't think of a more important time to recognize courage in the face of adversity, confidence to forge ahead, and character founded on strength. The next generation is watching us. They're modeling our behaviors, dreaming big and bold, and realizing the limitless opportunities that lie ahead. Thank you to the finalists and to the other amazing people in this room who recognize that our actions and words truly make a difference. I am immensely proud to be on the board of directors for Girl Scouts of Greater Iowa. I believe in our mission, and I believe that we are creating the future leaders. 2020 brought the loss of an icon, but I believe her words will forever inspire and drive change. As Ruth Bader Ginsburg once said. So now the perception is yes, women are here to stay. And when I'm sometimes asked when there will be enough women on the Supreme Court, and I say when there are 9, people are shocked. But there's been 9 men, and nobody's ever raised a question about that. So today, I ask you to continue to support Girl Scouts of Greater Iowa. I ask you to support building the next generation of leaders founded on courage, confidence, and character. I ask for your support in achieving the 9. On behalf of the board of directors, I thank you for your support, your leadership, and commitment to our community. A special thanks to our sponsors and donors, without whom this event would not be possible. In closing, in the words of RBG, if you want to be a true professional, you will do something outside yourself, something to repair tears in your community, something to make life a little better for people less fortunate than you. That is what I think a meaningful life is, living not for oneself, but for one's community. Many thanks for your continued support of our community. Today's event is made possible through the financial support of our donors and sponsors, including organizations such as Lincoln Savings Bank. I am truly honored to invite my friend, Mary Inbody, to say a few words on behalf of our presenting sponsor, Lincoln Savings Bank.
I'm Mary Inbody with Lincoln Savings Bank. And what a wonderful day. This is just amazing to look out over all of you and to be here celebrating together. To have the opportunity to recognize these remarkable people today and their accomplishments along with this great support from all of you is truly an honor for me today. This is possible today because of the unrelenting commitment to the Girl Scouts of Greater Iowa, led by Beth Shelton and her team. Beth's leadership shines through as she leads her team through these challenging times. They certainly had the opportunity to do just that this year. They don't see obstacles, they see opportunities. Opportunities to continue to support and shape the lives of young girls to find their best. The chance for all of us at Lincoln Savings Bank to support the Girl Scouts in presenting Inspiring Woman of Iowa aligns with the core value of ours in supporting our communities. One of the things we are deeply continued to do is to continue to support all the communities we are in across the state of Iowa. And we were actually recognized in 2020 as the top lender for women-owned small businesses by the Iowa SBA. For us to support the Girl Scouts in making our communities a better place is a great honor for LSB. I'm so moved to congratulate each one of the exceptional people who have been nominated today for lifting others up, making a positive impact in everyone's lives, showing your true best, and acting as mentors to those girls who are following in your footsteps. You have truly inspired us all. Thank you.
Thank you, Mary. We can't thank Lincoln Savings Bank enough for their wonderful support. Let's continue thanking our wonderful sponsors today. Thank you to our platinum sponsors, Community Choice Credit Union, Fearless, a business record initiative, Illuminated, Shable Solutions, and Taro International. A special thank you to Community Choice Credit Union for sponsoring the pre-event networking portion for those that were here in person, enjoyed this morning. Our gold sponsors, American Equity Investment Life Insurance Company, Bankers Trust, Denton's Davis Brown, Iowa Farm Bureau Federation, Knapp Properties, Polk County Board of Supervisors, Primary Source, who created the awards given to our honorees, Voya and Willis Automotive. Our silver sponsors are American Enterprise Group, Arog Legal Insurance, Atlantic Bottling Company, BH Companies, Brown Winnick Law Firm, DHI Group, Friends of the Iowa Commission on the Status of Women, Homemakers, Come and Go, Mid-Iowa Fertility, NCMEC, West Bank, and Wink. A thank you to our bronze sponsors, Business Solver, Casey's, Farmers Mutual Hail Insurance, Fem City Des Moines, Green State Credit Union, HR Hotline Associates, Iron Horse Wealth Management, Joseph's Jewelers, LWBJ, One Iowa, RSM, Salto Women, Sarah Noel Wilson, Shattered Glass Development, and Story Kenworthy. Thank you again to all of the sponsors for your wonderful support and in making this event possible.
Thank you, Brooke, and thank you to everyone who worked really hard to make today great and special to celebrate the work that girls and women in Iowa have done that are making the world a bit of a better place. You, in this room and online, are a part of the conversation, too. So we want you to take a picture and use the hashtag SheInspiresIowa. We need to fill our social media feeds with something inspiring and something positive. So make sure to do that during the course of this event. Today, we're going to be hearing from women who exemplify courage, confidence, and character. But before our next speaker comes to the stage, we would like you to get to know a confident Girl Scout.
Hi, I'm Grace Perrin. I live in Sioux City, Iowa. I've been in Girl Scouts for about 12 years, and I'm majoring in biology at Western Iowa Tech. My mom has always been a Girl Scout leader. She got me into it. I started off as a daisy, and I grew up all the way to be a senior and an ambassador.
Picking the Gold Award was tough because there were certain criteria you had to meet and it was hard to find something original. I just kind of thought about things I love. I love nature. I love everything in biology. So I leaned towards doing something to help the environment. We landed on building bee houses, wild bee houses for bees to live in as they migrate across the country. Bees are the number one pollinator. They give us the food we eat, they give us the plants we see, the air we breathe. They are extremely important to our environment. We ended up building 30 bee houses and we left them in different parks, different public areas that we know bees normally come, and we planted wildflower seeds everywhere we put those bee houses. I want to eventually go back and see that those bee houses are in use, that bees genuinely enjoy them. I want to see that the wildflowers grew. I just want to see progress in what I did. I learned a lot, not only about bees, but about myself and about those around me, how much people genuinely cared about something when it impacts the environment. Girl Scouting opens a path that you didn't know about. You make so many friends, you have so many new experiences you wouldn't normally have. You learn just so much in Girl Scouting. And I know that I have my Gold Award and that sets a foot in the door for me. I know that my Girl Scout background will get me very far. I think every girl deserves the same opportunities in Girl Scouts that I had. Please support our future leaders by donating to Girl Scouts of Greater Iowa today. Together, we are building girls of courage, confidence, and character.
Wow, what a sight, a full room. A record number of supporters, a record number of attendees, and a record number of sponsors. This is quite a day. Grace is such an example of the impact and time that Girl Scouts can make on a girl. I don't know about you, but I definitely did not have her confidence when I was a child. She is a go-getter, and she is already on the path to making incredible things happen. It makes you wonder how organizations like Girl Scouts make a difference in the lives of girls every single day. And we are the Girl Scouts, for the record. Not the scouts, because the girl is the part that matters. Just like this room of inspiring women. We are here to celebrate you, and we're also here to advance equality, inclusion, justice, and empowerment. And we stand for girls, because there is still a need to call out inequality and ensure barriers, bias, and discrimination do not hold people back. To the female engineer in the room, of whom it is expected you might take the team notes because you're the lone female, we see you. To the executive attending a conference who does not have access to a private space for nursing or pumping, we see you. To the caregivers who have sacrificed your own health, your own well-being, we see you. To perhaps maybe you're one of the 3.4 million women who have left the workforce in the past year because of the raging pandemic, we see you. Did you know that 75% of the time that caregivers with children at home were taking care of children this year, they were also working 75% of the time. I'm telling you, on that one, I see you. I've got three kids, and it's no joke. 2020 almost did me in. I had a day where I was crumpled on the kitchen floor, and I was sobbing, and I said, I cannot do this anymore. This is so hard. You guys, that was March 22nd of 2020. That was like 3 weeks into the pandemic. Turns out you can do it. It's on behalf of so many special people. Four people in this room were part of the people that were my support network and saw me at my worst. What a tough year. To every single trailblazer who has ever had a manager not give you the role, not give you the promotion, not give you the traveling experience because they assumed you might not want it because of your personal life, we see you. So here I am, bearing my soul, and guess what? Sometimes my shoulders even, to make a very important point. My female attributes, or lack thereof, are not the part of the ecosystem that is broken. We are so accustomed to measuring women based on what makes us comfortable, the things we can see, from our lips to our hemlines to our heels to our tushes, right? The things that we can measure, too big, too small, too short, too tall. What if instead we were encouraged to stand up in who we are and what is uniquely ours? My gosh, can you even imagine if the next generation of leaders, the next generation of girls was taught to do that? Whether they're Chuck Taylors, Louis Vuitton, steel-toed boots, or running shoes. What if they were actually evaluated based on what they contribute to the world, based on their ideas, based on their strategies? Can you even imagine that? We see the distinct barriers that girls face, and we are here giving girls the tools they need to change the world, the tools that data says they still statistically need. And we are gonna help them grow in confidence and courage and character to change the world. And we see you, and there is something so human and beautiful about being seen. I have had so many privileges in my life, many of which I was born with. But also, statistically, I'm not exactly set up for total equality, right? I'm a female, and also I do have a physical disability. I only have one hand. And as a woman with a person with a physical disability, there are times this affects me professionally, yes, but there are far more times it impacts me personally. It impacts what I think about myself and who I think I am. If you've heard me talk about inclusion before, you may have heard me talk about a few of these barriers. So for instance, one of my greatest pet peeves on this planet is that I cannot use a pepper grinder. And restaurants think it's so fancy to put that pepper grinder on the table, and I have to eat bland food because of it. It's also really hard for me to open a bottle of wine, and I can't even hold a fork and knife at the same time, so I can't order a steak. The whole world is systematically set up for me to never have a great meal. It's tough, I'm telling you. 6 weeks ago, my family took a little trip. We went to the Great Smoky Mountains. What a nice little trip. We drove there, and we visited Dollywood, and there was this alpine coaster there. It's a little cart. You get in, you put a seatbelt on, you ride down a hill. That pretty much sums it up. My three-year-old son walked through the gate to get on his little cart. No problem, let him right through. I went to walk through the gate, and someone said, excuse me, ma'am, we're gonna need you to step aside. Now, they have signs everywhere that say no loose items, no cell phones, and I had my cell phone in my bra, and I was like, oh my gosh, they were serious, and I am gonna be put in an amusement park holding cell. That is not a joke. That's not actually what they wanted. They said, ma'am, no, we noticed that you don't have a hand, and we're gonna need you to sign a waiver. You guys, I was a college athlete. I can type 80 words a minute. For gosh sakes, I'm taking guitar lessons. Can you imagine that phone call to my instructor the first time? Like, I'd like to take lessons. Here's the thing. I want to do it with one hand. And I had to sign a waiver, right? My three-year-old son walked through the gates. We gauge his intellectual growth right now based on how many verses of Paw Patrol he can sing. And they made me sign the waiver. For me, not for him, because of me. So, I think we can do better to see people. I think we can do better with inclusion. It has taken me decades longer than it should have to embrace my very distinct mix of skin and limbs. And I work on my confidence every single day, and I'm not quite there yet. Confidence is having an accurate sense of who you are, not arrogantly more, but my gosh, not meekly less. It is most certainly not an accident that now, in my 40s, I am choosing to be wholly me, even the parts that don't conform. In fact, especially the parts that don't conform. So how do we get girls there today? Into confidence, into acceptance, into embracing the fact that they are not the part of the system that's broken. We get them there with mentorship, we get them there with friendship, we get them there with inspiration, we get them there with connection, and we get them there with Girl Scouts. So can you imagine some of my experiences in life? And far more, all the many ways we have not been seen as humans. And now imagine that for a child, still learning her way in the world, struggling with confidence, feeling the barriers that are set before her. And who sees her? Let me tell you one example of how Girl Scouts does this, because in addition to being the CEO of the organization, I'm a local troop leader. It's really fun, and it helps keep me connected to the front lines of our mission. So one of the girls I get to lead is Bella. Her name is Bella. She joined our troop this fall, and she is dynamic. I'm sharing this with permission from the family, and she is going to change the world with her ambition and her resilience and her eternal optimism. And Bella is also in a wheelchair. She's missing portions of both of her legs, and she took to our troop right away. And she is curious and intelligent, and she openly answers questions to any girl in our troop. And guess what? I can tell you, because I look a little different on the smallest of scales, kids are curious, and they don't hold back when they want to know what happened, right? And Bella handles it like a champ. She is so confident. Her independence shines through in every single thing she does. Bella joined our troop in September. 4 weeks later, we took our annual camp out to camp. 4 weeks. She hardly knows any of us. She hardly knows her trusted leaders, and she went to camp with us. And, you know, we did all the camp things you do. We sang campfire songs. We cooked food. I think we burned some food. We went for some hikes. And Bella told me it was the first hike she had ever taken. No one, not one person in our troop, not one troop leader, not one adult, and not one kid assumed Bella could not do it. No one assumed. No one pulled her aside and said, hey, kiddo, we noticed you're missing your legs. You're going to need to sign a waiver. No, because that's not how you see people. You say, what do we need to do? What possible barriers might this human face, and how do we make sure we compensate for that? How do we make sure we see her? How do we ask her? How do we empower her to be her very best? She loved that hike. She said she cannot wait to go to our next camp out. She was one of our top cookie sellers this year, and she said next year she's going to take the most aggressive hike we have. She felt what it is we all want and what I was missing at that stupid alpine coaster and every time I have to pick up a pepper grinder, which is just to be valued, not on what's on the outside, but for her authentic attributes, for her resilience and what she brings to the table. Not every single girl we serve is in a wheelchair, but I promise you, every single girl we serve is yearning to be seen, is yearning to be valued for the very best she can be. So that in 10 or 15 years, when they are sitting in a room like this, they know how to negotiate for equal pay, they look for those leadership roles, and they ask for a voice at the table of impact in the world. These girls will have the tools. These girls are our future, and we have one purpose as an organization, to make their future as bright as possible. So let me reiterate one more time if you didn't hear it the first time. Being female is not the part of the ecosystem that is broken. All of the proceeds from today's event serve girls like Bella and other girls that are going to be changing our future. They're going to be our leaders. They're going to be our nine. Every single dollar raised today ensures girls can sign up and get started with Girl Scouts. A $100 donation provides the gift of membership for 4 Girl Scouts. We serve about 13,000 members. With your support, girls like Bella, girls like Grace, and every other girl that's yearning to be seen, every other girl that's going to be leading the world has an opportunity. Through their experiences, they develop tools to equip themselves and to change the world. You can give however is most convenient for you. For those of us here in person, there was a pledge card placed at your table. You can visit our website. You can also text to give, or you can even mail in a donation, or, of course, via PayPal. The options are listed on the screen. $100 a year comes out to about $8 a month. For $8 a month, you can provide membership for 4 Girl Scouts and remove the barriers for them, making them capable of making the world a better place. I am so excited we're here today. When I called up Joe Biden about 3 months ago on the phone, I said, hey, what, tell me a little bit about the CDC in late May. He's like, you're going to be good to go. So thank you. Thank you for that. So I just want to remind you that this room, you supporters, you are the fuel for the future. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Beth. Well, last year we expanded who we recognized at Inspiring Women of Iowa, celebrating the ecosystem surrounding women. Those who lift them up, support them through workplace policies, advocating for what is right, and standing side by side with women to further the advancement of women's equality. The Inspiring Business for Women's designation is given to businesses that show incredible support for women. They might have workplace policies like maternity and family leave, family-friendly practices, women in leadership roles, special women's initiative, and or equal opportunities for women. These businesses have demonstrated their support for women's equality and advancement in the workplace. We are so excited to honor the following businesses with the Inspiring Business for Women designation. Please help me congratulate BH Companies, Breathe Physical Therapy and Wellness, DHI Group, Golden Openings. We see you over there, Golden Openings. Kading. We see you too. Nick Mick and RC Group. Yeah, let's give it up for them. Thank you to all of these businesses for everything they have done to continue to do for women in our community. So next up is the Inspiring Advocate for Women Award. So what does it mean to be an advocate? It's kind of a buzzword right now, right? Well, the word advocate is defined as someone who supports or promotes the interests of a cause or a group. The Inspiring Advocate for Women Award is a person of any gender who advocates for women's equality. They are someone who shows commitment for the development of women leaders, stands up for women in their workplace, and removes barriers that women commonly face. The finalists for this award have done just that and even more. So make sure to check them out in today's program to read more about these amazing individuals. But first, let me tell you a little bit more about them. Our finalists are Jen Carruthers. She is a force in the Des Moines community. Her work, yeah, let's hear it up for Jen. Her work is rooted in a commitment to see equality and more representation for women and LGBTQ folks. As the owner and founder of 1111 Productions, Jen's goal is to connect the best and brightest talent and to enhance our great city. Jen is also the current president of Capital City Pride. When asked about why she chose to be so involved, Jen says, "I deal with discrimination almost daily because I don't fit in the box of what it means to be a stereotypical female, and I want to be a pioneer for acceptance of our marginalized people. The only way that our community gets better," Jen says, "is and more productive, is when we experience more cultures mixing on a regular basis, because that's when you see minds changing and worlds thriving." Eric Dominguez is an advocate for powerful female voices. As a speaking coach, the majority of his clients are women. With his support and guidance, his clients craft and share their vulnerable stories, speaking their truth on stages and creating confidence. What matters to Eric is not just the deliverable, but the support and nurture during kind of those messy middle parts of growth. According to his nominator, "Very few men I know lift women up and celebrate their voices and potential as proudly and as energetically as Eric." Eric uses his social media platforms to tell the struggles he encounters, as well as his methods to overcome them while being vulnerable. Through this openness, he helps others become advocates for themselves and reminds us that we are our own best advocates. Up next, Erica Douglas, otherwise known as Coach D. Erica founded She Plays. It's a nonprofit organization to encourage, educate, and empower female athletes to be confident on and off the field. She Plays grew out of Coach D's personal experiences as an athlete from childhood through college, as well as her decade of coaching high school girls track and field. She spent her youth trying to be one of the guys. She beat them in the middle school mile. I was one of those girls too. Took them on head-to-head in gym class or on the playground. She was determined to play. She grew and changed, maturing to appreciate that she was different from all those boys that she used to be faster than. She now knows that those differences are what set her apart and make her unique. A female athlete, that is. Coach D is there for the girls who play to have a voice, to hear someone say, "I see you, I hear you, and you will be okay." And Lydia Wolken is up next. She's a rural sex abuse advocate at Access. She advocates for women every single day, using her knowledge of community resources, trauma-informed skills, and immense compassion for others to provide support and tools and to ensure that survivors are cared for. She always finds a way to better herself and broaden her knowledge to better support the individual she works with. She balances being a wife, a mother, an advocate, and a friend without missing a beat. Women have superpowers like that. Her husband also works as a paramedic, which means she often does these things all while being a primary parent for 24 plus hours at a time while he's at work. The COVID-19 pandemic has made providing advocacy to these survivors more difficult, but she has adapted and persevered to keep providing the best care possible. Once again, congratulations to our Inspiring Advocate for Women Award finalists. Be wondering who gets this recipient, or who the recipient is, who gets this award. I've been up since 4:30. Earlier, really. The recipient of this award is an educator, a coach, a dad, a small business owner. Since joining the Des Moines community in 2016, his mission has been to lift others, especially people of color and women, through knowledge, support, empathy, and unwavering leadership. Congratulations to Eric Dominguez, our inspiring advocate for women honoree.
I want to acknowledge that I'm a man winning this award, and that I haven't always been an inspiring advocate for women, that my bias and my privilege oftentimes, and my ego oftentimes prevented me from lifting women up. And I really took what Beth said to heart, that being female is not the problem with the ecosystem. And I'm so grateful to be recognized for this and to be recognized for creating a safe space. And I want to talk to the men briefly, that men, we get to do more work. We get to heal and find the deep wounds in ourselves to be able to create safer spaces for everyone. And thank you to all of the women that I know and that I don't know, that inspire me and support me and love me every single day. Thank you.
And we didn't have to cut the music, Eric. Kept it nice and sweet. No, just kidding, we don't do that here. No, we don't do that here. Okay, so now we're going to talk about the inspiring women we are honoring today. Women of courage, confidence, and character, who are doing their part to make the world just a little bit of a better place. We are excited to introduce this year's finalists and have you learn a little bit more about them through video. Let's meet our Courage Award finalists.
One of the reasons that Krista is so inspiring is because of the challenges and hurdles and barriers that she's overcome in her life. She grew up in the foster care system here in the state of Iowa. Both of her parents were incarcerated for various reasons, but Krista never let her humble beginning stop her from really just chasing after her dreams. In addition to her work formerly at Job Corps and now with the Workforce Development Board, she has started two nonprofit organizations specifically designed to help young people who didn't have those opportunities that a lot of young people have. And she said, I see a need, I'm going to fill that need, and I'm going to help provide opportunities for these young people who don't have maybe what would be those typical pathways open to them for workforce opportunities. Krista is inspiring because she lets absolutely nothing stop her from achieving her dreams and her goals, but more importantly, helping others achieve their dreams and achieve their goals. And her number one pathway for doing that is education.
Chelsea absolutely exemplifies courage in everything she does, in her day job and in all of the additional efforts that she supports at Rockwell Automation. Certainly being a woman in the field in the industrial automation industry is not easy. Her courage in doing the bystander intervention training was outstanding. We were asking people whose day job is not HR or diversity to come in and talk about the experience, that gray space of, oh, we need to have a conversation about something that's going to be really uncomfortable and difficult before it becomes a legal issue. And she was willing to be able to do that. You have to be willing to be vulnerable. And so she really kind of had that great balance between vulnerability and courage that I think really what makes her so effective at what she does. And so her willingness to raise her hand, to speak up, to step out, to put herself in situations, again, even when she doesn't have all the information, but she knows that she can make a difference just by being there, that's what I truly find inspiring about Chelsea.
Carla is joy. She is luminescent. She walks into a room and she's just a big hug in her essence of who she is. Carla is extraordinary at writing about health, wellness, self-care, food, anything that has to do with how we take care of ourselves, nourish ourselves, or keep our bodies doing what they need to do. But she is so much more than a writer. She is someone who takes her personal experiences and then translates that into a group narrative that we're all able to read and enjoy and connect to. She is one of the strongest people I know, and I say that meaning that she has integrity to her core. She shows up as love, and she shares with us things that are deeply, that used to be deeply painful. And that in and of itself, that bravery, that courage, is what keeps us so connected to Carla.
The reason I nominated Cheryl for the Courage Award is because so many people are dealing with issues today and they have to have a lot of courage to get through the day. However, Cheryl has had to have a lot of courage to get through the decades. Cheryl started off having an opportunity to prove herself, and that's exactly what she did in a male-dominated industry. When people thought that she probably would not go places, she went to the opposite extreme, and she is always considered one of the top in the insurance industry. She has also shown so much courage in getting out of an abusive situation, in getting out of situations that were harmful to her and her family, and to just get up and get moving after having such a devastating situation with a family member is beyond what most of us would ever have to go through, and yet she has always come through with flying colors.
Congratulations to our amazing Courage Award finalists. Our Courage Award recipient has shown courage her entire life. Residing in the foster care system until the age of 9, she defied the odds and overcame barriers. To her, education represents a tool to chisel one's way from a cycle of poverty. Her personal mission is to help others overcome seemingly insurmountable barriers that no longer need to exist. Congratulations, Krista.
Telling one of my friends on the way up, I was like, well, I'm definitely not going to win, so I don't have to prepare anything. But I just like to say that courage, I don't think, is maybe the thing that you see after somebody's done the thing, right? And I don't know that I would necessarily consider myself the most courageous person, but I do know that I've drawn courage not only from God, but from the people I needed in the moments that I needed it the most. So to all of you that support the women around you, they draw that courage from you when they need it. So just thank you all for being here, and thank you for the opportunity and this really cool plaque.
She has a great example and role model in you, Krista. Okay, I got all emotional with that. Gotta find my place, hold on. Okay, up next is the Confidence Award finalists.
If I were to describe Olivia, I think she is just really phenomenal in her ability to advocate for not only herself, but also other people. Olivia started her own doula service company, which is really important for not only Des Moines, but Iowa, because we do not have very many Black doulas in our state. Doulas support pregnant people and either before birth, during birth, or sometimes even postpartum and after birth. So they provide a variety of services. And having people that are Black serve as doulas is especially important because here in Iowa, Black people are most impacted by our maternal health crisis. She is stepping into that space in a way that there hasn't been, at least to my knowledge, access to doulas that represent marginalized communities. I am just inspired myself by how she sees an issue and is willing to present a solution.
When I think about who personifies confidence, Katherine Harrington comes to mind. In almost every interaction, her positive spirit and her confidence just are infectious. One of the things that's so inspiring about Katherine is that she is an idea person. She's able to have a vision, she's able to have a dream and brainstorm about things without shooting down ideas, always saying yes, yes, yes. And when you're around somebody who believes everything is possible and who has the confidence to go for it, I think it makes everyone around her believe that things are possible, or at least dreaming big is possible and really important. Katherine is a role model to women and girls, really, I think, through her confidence and positivity that you can have a big dream and you'll figure it out. Just go for it. Just don't say no and you'll figure it out.
The first thing that comes to mind when I think of Manisha is force of nature. She embodies everything so clearly that she believes, that it sometimes is breathtaking that someone of her scale, Manisha is tiny, can put off the type of energy and power that she does. Manisha really is a social justice advocate that is working tirelessly, whether she's on the clock or off the clock, to create change in the world around equity and ensuring that everyone has what they need. Manisha's journey started in Nepal and took her to Canada and all over the world. And that started when she was very young. And I believe that Manisha's moral compass is so finely tuned and has been probably her entire life that that really drives what she does and who she is.
When I think of a way to explain Amy, I would say she is a bright candle in a dark room. You know, you always know where she's at, and no matter how you're feeling when you walk in a room, maybe you've had a bad day, you are just drawn to her. And she will brighten your spirit and your day just by smiling. Currently, Amy serves as a city councilwoman for the city of Dallas Center. And when she was thinking about taking on that role, I think she had a lot of questions and just, could I fit this into my schedule? What does this look like for my family life? And I'm really excited that she took that leap because I think she's the perfect person to represent her area and to show women in her community and her family that you can really do anything. When I nominated Amy for this award, I thought more about the confidence that she instills in other people, because there have been moments for me personally, and I know for other people, where I have needed a little bit of a confidence boost. And she has always lifted me up, and I've seen her lift other people up. So I think that not only does she have confidence in herself, obviously, but the fact that she puts everyone in a mirror, and she really makes you look at what you're capable of doing.
Congratulations again to our Confidence Award finalists. The recipient of this award is dedicated to focusing her efforts on creating a just and equitable society for all. A native of Nepal, she has brought her confidence and brilliant mind to a number of efforts that positively impact whatever community she's serving. She has shared her gifts in Africa, Southeast Asia, Washington, Dubuque, Davenport, and our great city of Des Moines. Congratulations to Manisha Paudel, our Confidence Award recipient.
So this is going to be my Oscar moment because I really didn't know I was going to get this. Thank you so much. And I even put my coat on because I figured I wasn't going to come stand up here. and my family is here. It's probably the largest table right now because I have a 2.5-year-old niece who I wanted. I know she's on her phone right now, but, you know, I wanted her to to really see this, but also my family visiting from Nepal. And they kept saying, oh, I think it's going to be you. And I said, no, I think they would have told me to prepare a speech. So no. but yeah, thank you so much. And, you know, when I say if I get an award for creating a just and equitable society, I can't just accept it for myself. So kudos to everyone that was there. Because truly, the world cannot be equitable or just by just one person doing the work. It requires all of us. And Olivia, kudos to you for doing the work, because I know it's everyone that was nominated and it was the finalist, but I really want to highlight someone who truly sees a need and addresses it immediately and goes through a lot of barriers, and knowing how people of color, especially Black people, especially queer Black people, that go through this world with a lot of barriers. I do want to uplift that, and I want to say congratulations to Olivia and everyone. Please don't see this as me just mentioning one person, but I really want to uplift that one person who constantly inspires me. So thank you so much. And thanks to my mom.
Always deserve a shout out. Yes, shout out to all the moms in the room too. Okay. Okay, so we are moving on to our final award for the day, and that is character. Let's meet the Character Award finalists.
So Nora's character, I mean, she's the type of person that is gonna give you the shirt off of her back, but then she's gonna go to the store and she's gonna find a coat in your size that's cute. She's gonna bring it back to you in case you're cold. She always goes above and beyond. She's magical because she's so selfless, and her heart, she just has a heart of gold. She is a servant leader. In everything that she does and touches, she is there to empower people. Nora has just a really cool story. Her parents came here from Egypt to build a better life for her, and she has passed that on. Nora is brilliant. She went to college at 16, and she was building software programs and traveling all over the world implementing these software programs. And in her late 30s, she just woke up one morning and thought, I'm gonna do something different where I can have a high impact on people's lives. And she became a real estate agent. I mean, talk about a switch, right? And she focuses so much on making sure that people have access to fair housing. And she's not just trying to make the most money when she does a sale. She wants to make sure that the people who buy the house have the money to buy the curtains that they want for the house too.
I would probably best describe Erin's character as strong. Midwest mom and wife actually started everything. She's a postpartum doula and things like that. And then she started writing some posts for the gentleman who owned Des Moines Parent. So she purchased Des Moines Parent and started doing the blog. And, you know, like I said, she took it to the next level with the app and all the reviews. And I don't probably know as much about the inner workings of Fem City as I do about Des Moines Parent. You know, of course, it seems like she kind of guided it through a tough situation. Probably both Des Moines Parent and Fem City, because the pandemic wasn't kind of those type of industries that relied heavily on like in-person gatherings and, you know, going on adventures. What she sets her mind to and starts, she does finish it. You know, the Midwest Mom and Wife started, and, you know, then she picked up Des Moines Parent, which she's seen through. You know, she picked up Fem City, which she's seen through. Being a Girl Scout troop leader, which she's seen through.
The best way that I would describe Molly is she is a master of connections. And I've kind of coined that term for her, but it's so true. I always say she could introduce me better than I could introduce myself. She can find something about me that I wouldn't even think to be relevant to the person that she's talking to or introducing me to, and somehow connect me to that person in a way I didn't even know I needed to connect to them with. Molly's character does just leave an impression everywhere she goes. You walk into a room and you say, "Oh, Molly told me to talk to you," and you can just see people's faces light up. One of the great ways that Molly and her husband Dan give back is they're like a two-man salvation army, just finding all these different things that people in the area need and sourcing those resources for them. Not only is she just an amazing person in how she treats people, but she's also a very successful businesswoman and has a long resume to prove it. And just that in itself is inspiring to women that are trying to grow their career.
I think the mere presence of Trisha is inspiring. You think about a woman who has grown a business, has grown two businesses, very successful businesses. Trixie's is a well-known Des Moines name. But then you also think about what she has done and what she's done to give back to the community. She takes her passion and she makes the world beautiful. You never walk away from her without laughing. She has the best sense of humor in the world. She can always make you crack up. But I also think you feel just loved. She runs two businesses. That's enough in itself. But she has Dreamcatchers, this beautiful foundation where we give back to the community. She also took on a grant with John Stoddard in their cancer center, where individuals can come in and get haircuts. They can feel beautiful, maybe when they're going through really hard treatments. So it's just all of that that she can take on, and that just speaks volumes of who she is and her character. And you can't just help but love her.
Congratulations to our Character Award finalists. So the recipient of this award goes to a woman whose story is one of hard work, persistence, and compassion. With her salon's record of giving back to the community, she started a foundation to provide complimentary salon services to those who need it most. Every interaction with her is filled with joy, passion, and walking away feeling uplifted and empowered. Congratulations to Trisha Rivas, our Character Award recipient.
Goodness gracious. I won't say too much because I know that I'll like snot ugly cry. But I just have to give so much love to those three tables that are over there. I would not be here at this podium without the love and support of my family, my mom, my dad, my husband, my son Colton, and sincerely so many of you that are sitting in this room. You support me day in and day out. You love me, you call me out on my crap when I need it, and I am unbelievably honored to be amongst this honoree with Nora and with Aaron and with Molly. So sincerely, thank you, thank you, thank you.
A big congratulations to all of our finalists in our Inspiring Businesses for Women, Inspiring Advocate for Women Award recipients, and especially to our Courage, Confidence, and Character Award recipients. Let's give another round of applause. You all have been so inspiring to all of us in the room, and we thank you for the examples that you set in your daily lives, and really hope that that gives our girls hope for the future. Thank you all for sharing in our celebration today, whether you're here in person or watching us virtually in your pajamas, we get it. We all appreciate your support, and we hope that you leave here feeling really inspired today. Thank you to our sponsors too, and our finalists and the award recipients for showing up for women and girls here in the Des Moines area. There is still a chance to donate and make an impact for girls in our community by filling out your pledge cards on your table or by visiting the links on the side of your screen, and you know where to find those. You can also text GIVE, G-I-V-E, to 515-278-2881. And for those of you in person, Girl Scouts will be at the doors to collect those pledge cards too if you fill those out. There is still the opportunity to purchase a raffle ticket to complete the mural outside in the lobby, so make sure to do that as well. We hope that as you seek inspiration in your lives every day, remember, it takes just one interaction to leave an impression on a girl. And with the inspiring women we have recognized today, we know we will see you, your daughters, and your granddaughters achieving great things to make the world a better place. Thank you for joining us this afternoon.